The bait of the day, a discontinued Ozark Mountain Woodwalker in one of my favorite patterns. Get your Charlie Campbell freak on. That's kind of creepy. Welcome back to Bassin 101, guys. Todd here. We're helping others to keep it simple. You're probably wondering about the title of the day, which is basically the worst thing that can happen. Wonder what that could be. Y'all ready to run and gun? It's time for blast off. Let's go. Okay, guys, like it says in the title, what's the worst thing that can happen? You might be thinking your truck breaks down on the way to the lake. You blow a tire on your trailer. You forgot to put gas in the boat. Or you cook it all the way to the lake, sit down to see, get ready to fire that thing up and realize you left your keys at the house. Yeah, that's a really stupid thing, isn't it? Yeah, stupid. But I was 17 years old. Give me a break. Anyway, worst thing that can happen. In reality, it's time off of the water. If you're trying to keep things simple, guys, and you're trying to simplify your tackle, and you're trying to do all this other stuff, the worst thing you can do is spend time off, because your brain starts wandering around. To keep it simplified, if you're used to fishing once a week, several times a week, maybe even once a month, and all of a sudden you're off a week, 2 weeks, a month, 2 months, whether it's just life in general, you just can't get to the water, maybe the weather's really bad, maybe the water conditions are really bad, it doesn't matter. That's when your brain starts, and pretty much you buy into everything you see. We're guilty of it. All of us are guilty of it. I mean, you're watching YouTube, you're watching TV, you're reading articles, you're seeing stuff on the internet, you're messing up by going to websites, you know, from Tackle Warehouse to Bass Pro Shops. It doesn't matter. That's a very dangerous thing for all of us. And it makes you buy into things that maybe is just not you. Maybe it's just not your way of fishing. I'm guilty of it. I normally don't put a lot of money into things that I've never tried before. I mean, I would definitely look for the originals, or I'll look for things that I've actually seen on TV or seen on YouTube or seen on the internet that work. And by the time I get to the water, I don't like this. We're all guilty of that. So that's one of the danger things right there. Another thing is you begin to think of special situations. You know, I want to be ready for muddy water, flipping heavy grass. I want to be ready for clear water, fishing the ledges. I want this, that, and the other. Okay, where do you normally fish? I mean, if you hit a lot of lakes in your state and they all contain different stuff, do it. But if you fish, let's say, mostly clear water, or you fish, let's say, Highland Reservoirs, which is deep water, or you fish natural lakes, which are shallow. You know, if you don't run into a lot of grass, or you don't run into a lot of muddy water, don't pack for that. Don't buy for that. Okay? But if you're the opposite, and all you fish is heavy grass, all you fish is staying to muddy water, you know, moving current, or whatever it is, then why are you going to buy a bunch of stuff for clear water fishing? See what I'm talking about? Don't do that. All right. Try to keep things simple so that you're not spending a half hour in your tie-up time the night before, and you're spending a half hour trying to pick one freaking rod to rig. Because, oh, I like this one, but I like this one, but I like this one, but I like this one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, we're all guilty of that. So be very careful of that. I'll get more into rods and stuff like that down the road. This is, you know, this is going to take several segments to break this down and make everything simple for you. Another thing, when you do finally get on the water and you've bought all this stuff and you've got, you know, your brain's fried and you've gotten all this stuff and everything, how long is it that you're on the water before you start regretting getting that stuff? You throw a rig or you throw a situation, let's say, not a situation, but you're throwing a particular bait or technique or whatever, and you start to realize, I don't like this. This is not me. This is hurting my arms, or this is boring, or this, you know, then you start to regret it. Well, that's what happens when you spend time off the water and you're not continually doing the stuff that you're used to doing. Because whether you realize it, you're a creature of habit when it comes to bass fishing. I mean, it helps to be, you know, diversified and be able to throw different stuff and be able to throw different techniques and this, that, and the other. Absolutely. But not all of us are pros. You know, I can remember back when I was fishing tournaments, I still had, you know, a handful of baits that were my crutch baits that kept me from finishing at the bottom of the pack every time. So, you know, I didn't listen to myself then either. So listen to yourself, guys. Another thing, how many times have you been on the water just to play around and you took one rod and reel, and you took one lure, and you were very comfortable with that? And maybe without even realizing it, you were very comfortable doing that. Perfect example, a couple of years back, there's a river right behind my house that I can throw a kayak on. It's pretty still. Water's got a dam a couple of miles down, so it's not like a fast-moving river. And I took with me on an afternoon run through to the evening time, I took nothing but my slider rod and my slider worms. And you know what? A couple hours went by. I caught a few fish. And a couple hours went by, and I realized, you know, I was like, you know what? I'm sitting back in this kayak, and I am so relaxed. And I'm just feeling comfortable throwing a slider worm. And I've been throwing slider worms for a long time, but it just hit me. I'm like, and I had realized I had never wished I had anything else with me. I just had that slider worm. And I just realized, hey, man, this is relaxing. I can remember, back in December, I think it was November, December, I went to a lake about an hour or so away here from the house with an old buddy of mine. And, you know, we were basically doing a soft plastic day. You know, we're challenging ourselves to do a soft plastic day. And I bet you I didn't spend an hour throwing, you know, from swim baits to worms to, I mean, you know, you name it. I took everything off the rods. I packed the rods up. I set them down in a John boat. I grabbed my slider rod. I threw my feet up on the deck and just kind of leaned back, had my legs crossed like this, and I was kind of leaning back with that slider and caught on almost a 10-pound bag and three fish. That's a good catch. I mean, the first one right off the bat, 4 pounds. You know, simplifying your techniques can work. And I realized when I did that and I caught myself throwing my legs up on the bow by the trolling motor, I was here going, good grief, man. It's like I'm sitting with a lazy boy fishing. It's just a relaxing way to fish. So when I finesse fish, that's what I throw. I don't throw anything else. I don't throw tubes. I don't throw dead rigs. I don't throw anything like that. Oh, and riggings. Oh, wait till I hit on those guys. You think things are new? I've been telling everybody stuff that everybody thinks is brand new, they were doing back in the 50s. We just, nobody knew it. But that's another subject. Anyway, I hope this helps out a little bit, guys. We're going to be touching some more on this subject down the road. So, that's a beautiful bait. So, stay tuned. Don't forget to click subscribe. Hit the bell notification so you know when new videos pop up. And guys, as always, may the Father bless you and keep you. And y'all take care until next time. Good luck.